Hello everyone, welcome to the Open Days admission session at Queen's University Belfast for applicants who are applying for university for entry in 2021. My name is Sandra Bloomer and I'm one of the admissions officers here at Queen's, and for the next 15 minutes or so I'm going to spend some time going through information which we feel will be helpful to you as you consider your options in applying to university. Firstly, we're going to look at the sources of information. We have prospectuses, and each university will have normally have hard copy prospectuses, and you may have had the opportunity to look at some of these at the moment. There is a wealth of information on university websites, and here at Queen's on our course finder, and we have provided the link for you, you will find under each course or courses that you're interested in applying to the entry requirements. Within the entry requirements section, you will find a section called selection criteria, and this is normally in a grey box, and in that you will find how we choose our students, so how we select our students for that course or courses that you are considering. For most of these, it is contained as text within the entry requirements and within that selection criteria. However, for the professional courses, i.e. medicine, dentistry, nursing, midwifery and social work, while it is under the selection criteria, it is provided in a PDF document which you will be able to open easily and read the information there that is provided for you. We have open days, and obviously you're attending the very first virtual open days at Queen's University. Former students, you may have parents or you may have guardians or sisters or brothers that have already been to Queen's University, and you can have a chat with them about courses and facilities that the institution offer. Obviously, we have informal visits, so Queen's University is open and you can come and have an informal visit and look at the facilities that the campus has to offer here. Also, our colleagues in domestic recruitment and events will be happy to organise an event if someone wants to come to visit the university. When you're considering submitting your application, it is important for you to consider closing dates. All applicants applying for entry to a university in the UK have to do so via UCAS. And the following closing dates we hope are helpful. If you're applying for courses in Oxford or Cambridge, or medicine, dentistry, veterinary medicine, the closing date is a very strict closing date of the 15th of October 2020, and it's important to remember that's at 6 p.m. in the evening. All other courses have a deadline of the 15th of January 2021, and again it's at 6 p.m. in the evening. The courses at Queen's that will close on that date are nursing, midwifery, social work, and actuarial and risk management. Applications that are submitted after the 15th of January, but before the 30th of June, are considered as late applications. And for the majority of courses, except for those I've already mentioned, at Queen's, we do consider late applications. The cost for applying to courses within the UCAS system are £26 if you use the full choice and you apply for five courses. So you may apply for five courses at one or two universities. You may apply for a different number of courses at one or two universities, or indeed you may have a mix of universities and obviously course choices. If you decide that you only want to apply to one course and one university, the cost will be £20. Once you've decided that you're going to apply, you do so via the online UCAS application system. And this is just a sample of obviously the first page that you will see. You will create a username and a password, and this will allow you to dip in and out of your application until you're happy with it and you feel that the application is complete and you want to submit your application to UCAS at that point. When you're completing your application, we would consider that there are four distinct sections to an application. The first is information about you: your name, your address, your date of birth, your telephone number, and your email address. What I would say is, if you're considering using your school email address, just to ensure that you have access to that account and that email address next summer. Once you have left school, you may not have access to your email address. So it is important for you maybe to consider, you may want to use an alternative like your own personal email address, so that you can ensure that if universities are communicating with you, that they will be able to obviously be in a position to make contact with you next summer or at any stage during the application process. Information about your qualifications. So this is in relation to both those you have completed. So for example, your GCSEs, your Scottish Highers, your Irish Junior Certificate, etc. Or maybe you've completed the first year of a part-time access course. But it is important that you put information there about courses that you have already completed. So if, for example, you were doing a mix of A-levels and the BTAC qualification, we would expect at Queen's to see the first year results for your BTAC for each unit. And then in the qualifications pending, we expect to see, for example, if you're taking A-levels, you're taking Irish Leaving Certificate, if you are taking Scottish Advanced Hires, completing a BTAC qualification, we will expect to see the detail there in the pending section. Everyone is required to complete and provide a personal statement as part of their application, and also a reference must be included. In relation to your personal statement, universities will use personal statements in different ways. But within your personal statement, we will expect to see your motivation and commitment to the course or courses that you've chosen. We will expect to see how you communicate, any achievements or leadership, voluntary work or skills that you may have built up over the years, and also any work experience. And this is particularly helpful if you're applying for some of the professional courses, because it helps us to build up a picture of the interests and any voluntary work or any experience that you have gained to date. Please remember that the personal statement information is subject to verification. You also are applying for courses, so you may have a mix of choices, and also the context of invisibility. So for example, if you're applying to three universities and you've maybe submitted two applications for two different courses at Queen's, we will only see the courses that you've applied to at Queen's. So the other courses that you've applied to and the other universities are invisible to us. Do remember that it is a common personal statement. It is important for those that are thinking of applying for nursing and midwifery that their personal statement very much focuses on the profession of nursing and midwifery if you're applying to Queen's. At Queen's, the personal statement for nursing and midwifery on your UCAS form is assessed, and that is what decides whether you're shortlisted for interview or not. I spoke previously about how we choose our students, and for those considering nursing and midwifery, within how we choose our students, we'll provide some guidance about what we expect to see in relation to nursing and midwifery. UCAS similarity detection is when there is a percentage, and it's around 30 to 32% of similarity within your personal statement and someone else's personal statement. So it is important to remember when you're providing your personal statement that it's unique to yourself. And then to check your grammar and spelling before submitting your personal statement. Your reference is the final part of your application, and that is normally provided by your teachers or an academic who's got experience of your work and your performance and your potential there. We will expect on the reference to see predicted grades. So if you're taking A-levels or BTEC or Irish Leaving Cert, etc., we will expect the teacher to have, or your principal, careers teacher, whoever is providing your reference, to have put on predicted grades. We will expect them to talk a little about your suitability for the course or the courses that you're applying for, and obviously your career aspirations and what has motivated you in applying for the course or courses. We will also expect, and it is helpful, if there are any extenuating circumstances, whether these are medical or personal, that they feel may have contributed to performance during your career at school. Your personal qualities and your interests and activities, and that helps to build up a picture of the young person and their interests in the course or courses that they are applying to. Some of the criteria when universities are assessing applications, some of the criteria that they use, that they take into account, are if there are subject requirements at GCSE and A-level. So for example, for engineering programmes, GCSE grades and year 13 performance, and this would be year 12 in the mainland in GB. Academic reference, including your predicted grades, your personal statement. Some courses will have interviews, and these are the professional courses at Queen's: medicine, dentistry, nursing, midwifery, and social work. And some other courses may invite applicants to submit, for example, in architecture, if you have not taken GCSE art to and have achieved at least a grade B, or are taking A-level art, you will be invited to submit a portfolio for consideration. Some universities will have aptitude tests, and the one that we use here at Queen's is UCAT for entry to medicine, and anyone who's considering applying to medicine and dentistry will be familiar with UCAT by this stage. Once we've completed that assessment, then universities make their decisions, and those are submitted via UCAS, and obviously then applicants have to reply. Universities can make one of three decisions, and that is an unconditional offer. So for most of you, you will have to still take examinations. You may be taking BTEC, you may be taking A-levels, Scottish Advanced Hires, etc., Irish Leaving Certificate, Access Course, etc. But most of you will have conditions to your offer. So if a university is considering making you an offer, you will have conditions, whether that's on achieving three A-levels or a certain percentage in an Access Course or a number of distinctions and merits in, for example, a BTEC qualification. Or the third decision that a university can make is a non-successful decision. And that will be where someone cannot meet the entry requirements that is actually published. Decisions can be expressed by universities in terms of A-levels, BTEC unit grades, Scottish Hires, Advanced Hires, Irish Leaving Certificate, for etc. at higher level. And these can be made in terms of grades or tariff points. At Queen's, we make our offers in terms of individual grades and individual units if it's a BTEC qualification. University deadlines for processing on-time applications. So for example, applications that have been received by the 15th of January. At Queen's, we work towards the 31st of March for the majority of our programmes. At Queen's, when we are processing on-time decisions, i.e. those applications that have been received by the 15th of January, we aim to make those decisions on the whole by the 31st of March. There are one or two courses which have very lengthy selection processes, and those are nursing and midwifery, and their decisions are normally processed on or before the deadline of the 6th of May. And for nursing and midwifery, it will probably be sometime around the 5th or the 6th of May that final decisions will be made. Social work is normally a little bit later as well, and those decisions are normally processed after all of the interview process is complete, and they will be processed in late April or early May normally. Applicants can make one of three replies: your firm and your insurance. Your firm acceptance is your first choice of course in university, and because you will normally have conditions, that will be something we call a conditional firm or a CF. You will then choose your backup choice, which is your insurance. And again, normally there are conditions attached to that, and that is your conditional insurance. If you've been fortunate to receive 5 offers, then unfortunately you will have to decline the other 3. Or if you've maybe received 4, you will choose your firm and insurance and then decline the other 2 offers. What is important to remember is that CF and CI, after your 14-day cooling off period, are not interchangeable. So you will have to approach universities if you decide that you may like to swap your CF and CI after your 14-day period of cooling off, where you can change your mind at that point. Obviously then you will go off and do your final coursework, your examinations, and then we will reach confirmation in August. And the good thing for yourselves is that for most applicants, you do not have to worry about sending your results to universities. Queen's, and indeed most other universities in the UCAS system, will receive examination results from UCAS for A-levels, for Irish Leaving Certificate, for Scottish Hires and Advanced Hires, and for BTEC Level 3 qualifications. Where you may need to send in your results to the university is, for example, if you're doing an access course, and the university will request that you forward those to the university, and that will be contained within your offer. So we will ask you to forward them where they, you need to do that by a particular date. Once then we've received all of the results, if you've precisely met the conditions, or indeed many applicants exceed the conditions of their offer, you are accepted to your firm choice, to your first choice university. So for borderline applicants, those decisions may take a little bit longer. And we always, what we will say is, have our applicants' best interests, and the decisions take a little bit longer because we're waiting to see if we can accommodate your request to be considered for your chosen place, obviously at your chosen university. So this is just a quick whistle-stop tour through the process from you considering about applying to university and researching your options through the application process up until the confirmation period in August, following the publication of all results. We hope that you have found it beneficial and helpful. However, if you have any further questions, so if you have looked at the courses you're interested in, you have researched the entry requirements and looked at how we choose our students and how we select our students for those courses, and you feel that you haven't found the information that you require, please don't hesitate to contact us by email at admissions@qub.ac.uk. Finally, it just remains for me to wish you all the best as you research your options and apply to university, and for your examinations and your coursework, etc., in the coming year. Thank you.